Good morning, cross country fans. We are live here at Noblesville White River Elementary School. If you have been following cross country, high school cross country in Indiana throughout the course of this season, you know that the excitement has really built up to this point of the season. Today, this morning, we are live Hamilton County Television along with HoosierXC.com. We are bringing you live the Noblesville Sectional. Arguably, or not so arguably, the best sectional in the state of Indiana. Like we said, the excitement is built all season long, and here we are at the IHSAA postseason. There are 32 sectionals across the state, and we are here live to you from Noblesville for what is probably the best, most competitive sectional from across Indiana. Last week, we were here live to you from Hamilton County Television and HoosierXC.com. And we were here for the HCC Cross Country Conference meet, and we had talked about the weather looking sort of like the Grateful Dead song Touch of Grey. Well, this week we have really basically the opposite. I think about the Beatles song Good Day Sunshine. It is awesome out here this week. We have ideal, perfect running conditions for the athletes. We have temperatures right in the lower 50s. It's going to be an easy day for the spectators to watch as well. Just can't wait to get started here. First race scheduled to start at 10:30. It's just after 10:15 now, so it's going to give us a little bit of time to set the field for you and get you set for the awesome action that we are all about to witness here at Noblesville. So again, good morning. We're live from Hamilton County Television. .com and from HoosierXC.com. My name is Scott Litskin. We've been bringing you coverage all season long here. While I have a moment, I wanted to take this opportunity to say hello to my family. Ella, Amelia, Chrissy, how you doing? It's great to see you guys. Are you available? Yeah, let's do it. We are going to actually start right now with a real quick interview. We are very, very fortunate to have the fine cross-country coach for the girls team from Carmel High School, Mark Ellington. Mark, thank you. Thank you for joining us here. Very kind of you. So we are about to start the boys' race. You've got a little bit of time before the girls' race starts, so thank you for coming on down. What are you hoping to see today? Expectations? What are you hoping happens for the Carmel Greyhounds today on the girls' side?
You know, it's kind of funny. We're having this conversation. We had it like a month ago the county meet, and I'm going to tell you it's kind of the same tone.
Yeah.
With it being the tournament, the idea was we're going to set the tone. So yeah. I think we're hoping to remind everybody in state because, you know, there's been other teams that raced last weekend, and certainly Columbus North ran a great race against us at Culver.
Yep.
We'd like just to let them know, hey, we're not sleeping, and we are ready to go. We're sharp and ready to roll. So I think we're looking to set a tone again today for the state tournament to get going, and we're looking to, you know, we're excited. This is going to be a nice tournament. It's going to be very competitive, and we're excited for the opportunity. So I think today is just going to we're just going to say, hey, we're here, and we want to get going again.
Great. And I know that for all coaches, so sort of one of the unique challenges is kind of trying to figure out who's, you know, which seven are going to race. Was that tough this week for you?
In some aspects, yes, which seven we were going to race. Because our attitude is we're picking 12 girls, and we're picking 12 that can race, and we are going to race you. And you should anticipate being ready to race. So we look at it. We look, okay, who do we have to get ready for at sectional, and then who do we have to get ready for regional? We want to have competitive teams, and we need to look for parts that are, you know, that complement each other well. So, you know, initially when you start going, it's a little bit of a challenge. But once you start to get a few pieces, it kind of pulls together, and we're excited with the group we're going to get to run with today.
Terrific. Well, good luck today. Thank you so
much
for stopping by.
Appreciate it, yep.
Yep. So, again, that was Mark Ellington, the head girls coach from Carmel High School. He's just done a terrific job over the years here as they are the defending state champions. I should say the five-time defending state champions. So, anyway, again, let's get you set for the boys' race that is about to start here in 10 minutes, okay? In 10 minutes, we're going to start the boys' race. We want to get you set for this incredible sectional race. We're so fortunate as fans and spectators to get to witness the depth of talent here at the Noblesville sectional. So let's talk about this boys' field. And you know what? Actually, before we start talking about the boys' team, sorry to leave you on a hanger, that cliffhanger there, but I did want to mention to those of you that are not aware of how a team advances out of this sectional level of competition. So we've got here is we've got about 13 teams that are going to be towing the line here at the sectional here at Noblesville. And the top five teams, the top five placing teams, they are going to advance on to next week's Noblesville Regional. Okay? So you got to finish in the top five teams to advance. However, there's another way to advance as an individual if your team doesn't advance. If your team doesn't advance, then if you are amongst the top 10 individuals that are not on one of those advancing teams, then you as an individual are going to advance on as an individual to next week's Noblesville Regional. So that would be what teams are really shooting for today, is a top five team finish. And if your team can't finish in the top five, then what you're really hoping for as an individual to be one of the 10 best individuals that isn't on one of those advancing teams, and then you're going to advance as well. And that is the exact same qualifying format which we'll have next week out here at the Noblesville Regional. The top five teams from the Noblesville Regional will advance, and the top 10 individuals not on one of those teams will advance. Okay, so now we got a couple minutes to talk about this boys' field. And we are, what a treat we have. We have five of the top 18 teams on our HoosierXC.com poll are here in this sectional. There is no sectional in the state that has five top 20 teams in that particular sectional. This is the only one. So what competition we're going to see here? We're definitely headed by the number one ranked Carmel Greyhounds. They are undefeated this season on the boys' side and girls' side as well. Again, they're ranked number one on our HoosierXC.com poll. They are ranked number 11 in the USA, in the United States of America, on the USMilesSplit.com website poll. They've been the county champions here in Hamilton County. They've also won the MIC title, their conference meet. So they are definitely the team to watch, and they are led by the defending individual state champion, Ben Veach, who will be racing today. He did not race at the Hamilton County meet, so it's going to be a real treat for us to get to see him. And with the conditions that we have here today, I would not be surprised if Ben is trying to shoot for a sub-15-minute race, which in Indiana, for boys, it would put him in an elite category, which very few young men have achieved for 5,000 meters. We'll get back to that later. Number two in the state of Indiana. So we've got a number one, number two matchup here, according to our HoosierXC.com poll. Number two are the Fishers Tigers after their impressive win last week at the HCC Championships. Well, guys, we don't stop there with 1-2. We've got a number one, number two, number three matchup today as the Hamilton Southeastern Royals are here in attendance, ranked number three on our HoosierXC.com poll. So, yes, folks, the top three teams in the entire state of Indiana are here at this Noblesville sectional. And that doesn't include the number seven, Westfield Shamrocks. And by the way, Westfield has been ranked as high as number two on our poll this year. So it's possible that you have the top four teams in the state here. We'll find that out on Halloween morning at the state championships at Terre Haute. Noblesville Millers are ranked number 18 this year on our HoosierXC.com poll. I should say this week. And they've had a fine season. They won the Meconequa Invitational. And are really looking like a strong team this year. So those would be the five teams that you would think would probably advance out of here, as they are the only top teams ranked in our top 25. But we have other teams in here fighting for those spots. We have Guerin Catholic, Hamilton Heights, Indiana Math and Science Academy, Lebanon, Sheridan, Tipton, Tri-Central, and University. That's the 13-team field. Five of those teams, the first five we mentioned, are the teams that are ranked in our HoosierXC.com poll. So that sets the field here in the boys' race team-wise. You can see on our camera angle right now, we're looking down at the starting line of the boys' race. In fact, I'm seeing Ben Veach right there in a yellow shirt over blue shorts, getting a necklace off. So Ben looks like he's ready to go. It's always a treat to get to watch him run and lead his number one-ranked Carmel Greyhounds out here at the Noblesville sectional. What a great morning it is. We're going to see some fast times this morning. We're going to see some fierce competition, no question. So let's talk a little bit about the individual battles while we just have a couple of minutes. As we mentioned, Carmel's fine champion Ben Veach is going to be the possible favorite, although I don't like talking about that word favorite, because in cross country, just like other sports, you just never know what's going to happen. But expect him to be challenged by Hamilton Southeastern's fine sophomore, Gabe Fendel. Now, Gabe was the HCC champion out here last week, ran 15:22. I imagine that he'll probably try to challenge Ben Veach, and if he does, I imagine that they will both probably go under the course record here at Noblesville, which I believe is 15:19. I would expect that record to go down today in these conditions from one or both of these young men. So Gabe Fendel is also the Hamilton County champion. So look for those two guys to kind of head the field. You'll be seeing Carmel, I believe, wearing gold over blue, and you'll see Southeastern looks like wearing white over blue. So that is something to look for in our awesome camera angles from HamiltonCountyTelevision.com. They do such a great job of getting out here and getting us awesome camera footage, and we're very, very grateful that they are here. There are a number of young men in this race that are also sort of all-state caliber athletes. I don't know if they're going to be state champion caliber athletes, although you never know. But we've got Trevor Thompson from Fishers, who ran 15:36 last week out at here at the HCC meet. You've got the duo from Westfield, Alec Hartman and Aaron Bennett, who are both 15:51 best last week at the HCC meet, and Alex ran 15:44 this year. You know, these are all state caliber guys. It does amongst other athletes who are in there as well. So what we're also going to try to do as the morning progresses is get you results, unofficial results, as quickly as we can. We're going to try to get you those unofficial results as quickly as we possibly can. We're talking with our timing company. They're going to get us results quickly. I will be trying to do some unofficial scoring, very unofficial scoring, I should say. As the runners cross the line at the finish line, you can see on our camera angle, we have our bottom right-hand corner there. We have footage of the finish line, and underneath that, we have a camera angle on the actual clock above the finish line, so you'll get a chance to see, as long as it works, what time the athletes are at when they cross the line and at various points throughout the race. The starter's walking up and down the line. He's wearing that red shirt that you can see there in our camera angle, and he is just checking everybody in, and in probably about 2 to 3 minutes, I imagine, he's going to be ready to shoot the gun here at the IHSAA Noblesville Sectional. We cannot wait to see the action live, brought to you from HamiltonCountyTelevision.com and HoosierXC.com. Come to HoosierXC.com. Every day we post new coverage and footage of high school cross country here in Indiana, rankings, photos, articles, teams of the week, athletes of the week. We post results. So head there for all things cross country here in Indiana, for high school cross country in Indiana, and head to Hamilton County Television as they cover tons of stuff. I mean, they have Hamilton County sports. They have movies. It's a great, great website. And if you would be interested in advertising on HamiltonCountyTelevision.com, go to their website, go to the contact area. They would be more than happy to talk to you about how you could be involved with HamiltonCountyTelevision.com. We are just about ready for the start here of the Hamilton or the Noblesville sectional here, the IHSAA sectional. You can see the starter giving final instructions to the field. It looks to me as though we've got Southeastern wearing white over blue. It looks like Lebanon is wearing all gold. It looks like the Westfield Shamrocks, as you would expect, in all green this morning. Carmel wearing gold over blue. Well, it looks like we've got Sheridan in all red. We've got Fishers in mostly red with some gray and black. We have Guerin wearing black this morning. Heights, Hamilton Heights in orange. We've got Tipton wearing blue, and then I do not get I cannot see from my angle down on the far end of the field who else is down there, but that'll give you an idea of what uniforms to look for. So again, the starter is headed out to the infield there, and he looks like he's about ready to start the race. So the excitement here is about to begin, and I do mean the word excitement. We again have 5 of the top 18 teams in the state here, according to our HoosierXC.com poll, headed by the number 1 ranked Carmel Greyhounds, and they are also ranked number 11 in the United States of America. So it's a treat to get to watch them, but they are also facing off against the number 2 and number 3 ranked teams in Indiana. The starter now has the flag out. He's blown his whistle. Gun is up. And we have now begun the 2015 IHSAA Noblesville Sectional. Teams are charging out at a good pace, as you'd expect on this unbelievably great morning to race. We have not had a morning like this in the last few. Last week we had some windy conditions out here. The week before that it was actually a little bit warm. The weekend before that we had torrential rain here in central Indiana. So the footing here is firm. The temperature is perfect. I would expect to see some fantastic times here at the IHSAA Noblesville Sectional today. So the field is now out, as you can see, and we will try to get you the best camera angles that we can. It's a very, very vast course here. It expands quite a bit of ground. But HamiltonCountyTelevision.com, the best there is covering cross country. We're going to get some great camera angles for you and give you the best footage that we possibly can. So here you can see our three camera angles that we have right now. Our main shot there is going to show the athletes as they head toward the west, as they we'll be heading towards about 800 meters into the field. You'll probably see the leaders momentarily as we're just about a quarter of a mile into the race now. You'll see them here in just a couple of seconds in our camera angle there. You see in the bottom right-hand corner the running clock. That's not an official time, but it's pretty darn close. So that'll give you an idea roughly of what these athletes are hitting with their times as they hit the finish line. And we'll have a camera right on the finish line, so you'll be able to see the finishers as they come in and see what times they run. There you can see our camera angle of the finish line as well. So lots of great stuff. Okay, there we see our leaders in view. I see that is Ben Veach with Gabe Fendel on his shoulder. It looks like Trevor Thompson tagging along. Those three have broken away by about 5 meters. I cannot see who's in fourth there. That to me is looking like a Hamilton Southeastern runner. So Southeastern has two of the top four, and Fishers, as they usually do, are out fast as well. So we're out pretty quickly here through the first 2 minutes of the race. And it looks like Southeastern, last week here at the HCC meet, Hamilton Southeastern was, I guess you'd say, the semi-favorite. And it looked like the Fishers Tigers kind of jumped them a little bit in the first mile of that race. And Fishers never came back. Well, Southeastern looks like they learned that lesson, and they are out well this morning. And it looks like we have a tightly bunched group with Fishers, Southeastern, and Carmel. Now, folks, we're only 2.5 minutes in the race, so there's a long way to go. But it looks like Fishers, Carmel, and Southeastern have positioned themselves well early on. And you don't win the race in the first 2 minutes, but you can certainly lose the race in the first 2 minutes by doing something foolish. And it looks like none of those three teams have done anything to put themselves out of contention. I know I spoke with the Carmel coach this morning, Coach Altavoet from Carmel, and he is, while he does have Ben Veach running, it looks like their fine senior Teddy Browning is not running today. So they're not necessarily at full strength here. On our angle right there, it's difficult to tell exactly who's who. I think our leaders have already come through. And that looked like it was the second group through. So the next camera angle we're going to see them at is with the runners at about 1,200, 1,300 meters into the race, as they're going to come around the bend toward the mile marker. We'll try to get you a split and at the mile marker. And we'll be able to, you know, get a little bit better view as they head towards the woods loops here at Noblesville. This is an unbelievably great course here. It's pretty flat, but there are a couple of hills. The Noblesville coaches and athletic directors do such a fine job of keeping this course in great shape. The course basically has two parts to it. You have the north part, which is what the athletes are on right now. We're seeing athletes coming up now. They'll be in our camera angle momentarily here on the north side of the course. Now, the south side of the course are two woods loops. It's a 1,000-meter loop that is run twice, and so we'll talk about that as the athletes get in there, because we will not be able to see much footage there. So here come our lead runners, it looks like, into our camera angle. It's really difficult to tell as they pop through really, really quickly. Maybe we'll get a little bit better angle as we hit the 420 marker in the race here. And that looks like Ben Veach in the lead, Gabe Fendel on his shoulder, and Trevor Thompson. Nothing has changed since we spoke last. It looks like those three have pulled away by a little bit more, in fact, if anything has changed. But the three of them are pretty close together, although it looks like right now Ben Veach has just opened it up by a step or two. Looks like as he's approached the mile marker, he's wanted to open it up a little bit, and it's 444, 445 at the mile marker, so nothing crazy fast, but not slow either. It's an honest pace. It's Veach, then Fendel, then Thompson, as they're about to head to the South Woods Loop here at Noblesville. still all three in contact. Looks like we've got a Southeastern runner in fourth, and we got a huge pack behind him looking like they're going to probably swallow him up, although he'll probably wind up in that pack as we get around and run this first Woods Loop. And that pack is, there are a ton of boys in it. Looks like there's probably 10 or 12 boys in there. I saw some yellow and some white and some red, so it looks like, again, as we mentioned about 2 minutes ago, that Fishers, Carmel, and Southeastern in a tight battle. It's early in the race as we're approaching the 5 minute and 30 second mark of the race. Looks like nobody has really separated themselves out as a team. That's pretty much expected when you have the number one, number two, and number three ranked teams in the state, as we do on our HoosierXC.com poll. This early in the race, looks like everybody's come to run. It was an honest pace through the mile, and even that trail pack that was trying to scoop up that second Southeastern boy who was in fourth place, looked like even they were through the mile marker at about 450, 452. So our pace is honest, which means we should see some good times at the end of the race here. And that is going to be one of the exciting things to pay attention to here, as the field is now into their first of two Woods Loops here at the Noblesville Cross Country Course. Again, it is a 1,000-meter loop, which the athletes will run twice. And after they finish that second Woods Loop, they then head back to that North Loop for the last 12 to 1,300 meters of the race, which would take, you know, approximately 4 minutes or so. So we talked last week about this part of the course here at Noblesville, this Woods Loop. It is typically an area that the race, the team race and the individual race kind of really separates. So it's at this point of the race where, you got some athletes who are very talented in this field, and they're going to be able to go out with the leaders or in that second pack for, you know, a good 5, 6, 7, 8 minutes of this race. And, you know, the leaders are going to have a number of boys run under 16:30 in this race. So, you know, they can hang around for 7, 8 minutes, maybe even 9 or 10 if they're really fit and talented. But things do start to separate here a little bit in the Woods Loop. So I'm guessing that lead pack will maybe be strung out a little bit as we see them come around here in a moment. But maybe by the second Woods Loop, we'll probably could get some idea as to who might be leading this team battle. Again, we have the number one, number two, and number three ranked teams on our HoosierXC.com poll. And look, there we see it is Ben Veach who has pulled free from Fendel. 7:30 into the race, he has a 3-second lead over Gabe Fendel. So 3-second cushion from Veach. They were tied as they headed into the woods at about the 4:45 marker. So within 3 minutes now, he has pulled away from Fendel. And we've got that big group which has strung out. It's single filed up quite a bit. And it looks like there's a gap at about the halfway point of that pack. Looked like after Eric Hoffman from Noblesville, that pack kind of split a little bit. Difficult to tell now. We have a big crowd here today, and right in view of where our angle is to see the athletes on this loop. So I told you we'd be able to get you some idea of scores here, but that isn't going to be the case. I apologize. As the runners now are heading back in, the lead runners are heading back into the Woods Loop for their second Woods Loop here. So right now we are at 8 minutes and 25 seconds into the race, and so athletes now are looping around heading towards the 3K. Now this is a 5-kilometer race. 5 kilometers is 3.1 miles. They're headed towards the 3K marker now. So we're definitely past the halfway point of the race, moving up here towards about 55-60% of the way done. And as you'd expect with the level of talent that we have here, it looks like it's still a very close race. And folks, with the number of teams here and the number of great teams here, it's going to look close as on the point totals pretty much regardless of, how far apart teams are separated by time. It's just not going to be easy for teams to separate themselves very far from each other in this small of a field. 13 teams here at the Noblesville sectional, and that's not a huge, huge field. And in fact, next week at the Noblesville Regional, it'll be down to 10 teams. So it'll be even more tightly bunched next week, obviously with even better competition next week here at the Noblesville Regional. So runners now are at past the 9:30 marker in this race. And we're going to see them coming around the bend here for the finishing up their second Woods Loop. This is an exciting morning, and I'll tell you what. Obviously, you know, we're down here at the finish line. We can't wait to see some finish line results here at the from the Noblesville sectional race. And we are anticipating some really quick times. And we saw Ben Veach, the leader in this race from Carmel, the defending state champion, you know, he's pressing the pace today on a fine runner behind him, Gabe Fendel, the sophomore from Hamilton Southeastern. So, you know, they are potentially on a sub-15-minute pace, which is super exciting for us here. Here's Ben Veach coming around the bend again. Let's see if he's extended his lead more. It looks like he has. He's at 10:24 now. As he is lapping runners, he'll be heading back out toward the north loop, and he is really extended his lead. He had a three-second lead the last time we saw him. I have not seen. There is Gabe Fendel. It is now up to a 13-second lead, and that looks like it is Alec Hartman or Aaron Bennett. It's a Westfield runner that's moved into third place that is kind of stalking Fendel. And if Fendel overextended in that first part of the race, he could be a vulnerable now. And you can see it looks like Carmel has three runners in the top 10 in the race. We're going to catch them as they come around, as we now see Ben Veach heading with about 1,200 meters to go. He has extended to a 13-second lead, and boy, does he look good as he is anchoring up towards the 4-kilometer marker. Ben Veach is going to challenge that 15-minute marker today, folks. That will be quite a treat for us to see that. We have not seen a whole lot of those races here on Indiana soil. We have Gabe Fendel in second place. And we have, it looks to me like that is Aaron Bennett in third place from Westfield. He is having a fine performance. Could be a big PR day for Bennett. We have not seen fourth place. So these three have really extended out now. Have really extended out. We still have not seen fourth place. There we go. We've got HSE. We've got, it looks like another Westfield runner there. Could be Alec Hartman possibly. We have Carmel's number two. We have Eric Hoffman from Noblesville. We have Fisher's is two and, no, number one and two. Looks like a second runner from Noblesville. Carmel now has established a nice front pack, as they look like they have established themselves in the lead in this race. It looks like it's anybody's race for second and third right now, though, and fourth, as Westfield looks like they have come ready to run today. So runners now have the leaders. I'm sure Ben Veach has passed the 4-kilometer marker by now. He's probably under 12 minutes, which means if he runs a sub-3-minute last kilometer, he is going to break 15 minutes. That would be an exciting thing for us to watch here live at Noblesville for the IHSA sectional. So we'll see if that does happen. We are at the 12:30 marker right now, and it looks like the team battle is a really, really close one as well. So it looks like Carmel had pulled out ahead at that 11-minute mark in the race. But it looked like Southeastern, Fishers, and Westfield were all pretty close together right there. So we are now moving up on the 13-minute marker of the race. So here's what we will look for here in the last 2 minutes of the race as runners start to approach the finish line. Number one, we're going to see Ben Veach, if he is able to hold on to the lead, and he was extending that lead, it seemed like, with every step. He had gone from a 3-second lead to a 13-second lead in a 1-kilometer span, and it looked like he had even extended that lead even more as he headed out at the 4K marker. So we'll see if he could break the 15-minute mark in this race. That'll be the first thing to look for. Then, the next thing to look for, it looked like Gabe Fendel from Southeastern was in second, but it looked like Westfield's Aaron Bennett was really moving up on his shoulder as the two of them had pulled clear of the field other than Veach. So that is something definitely to look for as well. Then we're going to talk about looking at the team battle. So Carmel is wearing the yellow jerseys over blue. Southeastern is in white over blue. Fisher is wearing red, gray, and black. Westfield wearing the all green. And it looked like while Carmel had a slight advantage, it looked like it could be a pretty close race between Southeastern, Fishers, and Westfield for that runner-up spot. Remember, the top five teams here all advance. So whether you finish second or fourth, it's really it doesn't impact your ability to advance to the next level of competition here in the IHSA tournament, which would be the regional out here next week. So we are now at 14:15. We are anticipating seeing Ben Veach from Carmel pull out into this camera angle. We are now at 14:25. He's going to break 15. There he is. Can he do it, folks? He's got 30 seconds to get here to break it. We have just passed the 14:30 marker. The old course record of 15:19 from Tito Medrano, it appears to be very much in jeopardy today, folks. It's really more a question of will it be a sub-15 race. Veach powering down the stretch at 14:45. And, folks, it is going to happen here today. We are going to see that sub-15-minute race as Ben Veach is your winner in 14:53. Congratulations to Carmel's Ben Veach. 14:53, unofficially your IHSA Noblesville sectional champion. So now the question is, who's going to come in second? It looks like Fendel has pulled away in that second spot, and he is going to be runner-up here. And will he dip underneath the old course record, which Ben Veach has broken? Nope. It looks like Fendel will run a very similar time to last week, as he will run 15:24 for runner-up honors. I said that was Aaron Bennett. It's actually Alec Hartman with a huge PR for Westfield in 15:30. Hartman in third place for Westfield. Who's going to come in fourth place now in this sectional race? Looks like Fishers has two guys. We have Carmel's second guy battling, and we have Aaron Bennett who pulls out ahead. So Westfield, then it goes Carmel, Fishers, HSE. Then we go Fishers, Fishers, Carmel, Noblesville, HSE. That looks like about the top 10. It looks like we're going to go Carmel, Fishers for our next two finishers. All of those boys under 16 minutes. Noblesville, then Carmel, then Fishers. It's a tight battle between Fishers and Southeastern for second. It does look like Carmel will be your champion here. People are pouring in now. That's Westfield's fourth boy in 16:20, just to give you an idea of how strong the competition is here. We're going to get you some unofficial results coming up shortly. Looks like Noblesville came to run today. 16:32, I think that was their fourth or fifth. We've got another Westfield boy coming in. Looks like that's their fifth. We have our first Garin runner in, first Lebanon runner in, then Fishers, our second Garin boy in. Our five teams have been pretty clear here, I think. It looks like those five teams that were ranked in our HoosierXC.com top 25 poll, it looks like those are going to be your advancers team-wise. Okay, I think we've got enough runners in now that we're going to be able to calculate some very, very, very unofficial team scores. So Carmel went 1, Southeastern went 2, Westfield Shamrocks went 3-4 in a fine performance from their front-running duo. Carmel in 5th place team finisher. Fishers in 6th. HSE's second runner in 7th. Fishers went 8-9. Carmel went 10. Noblesville went 11. Southeastern went 12. Carmel in 13th place. Fishers is 4th. Then Noblesville in 15th, the Noblesville runner. Carmel finishes out their scoring with a 16th place finish. 17th place is Fishers is 5th, it looks like. Southeastern in 18th. Carmel in 19th. Noblesville's 3rd in 20th. Southeastern in 21st. Westfield's 3rd in 22nd. So that's 22, 23, 24, Westfield 25, 26, Noblesville 27, and 29, and Westfield's 5th and 30th. So we're going to get you some unofficial scores here. It looks like Carmel scored 29, 39, 45 points for the win. It's looking like Southeastern had 39, 51, 58, 60, and Fishers had 31, 40, 48, 54. So it looks like Fishers edged Southeastern again this week. 50, these are unofficial, folks. 55, 77, 84 for Westfield. And it looks like we got 30, 56, 76, 86, 91, 102 for Noblesville. So we've got very, very unofficially here. We've got Carmel with the win at 45 points. This is unofficially. Carmel with 45 points. We had Fishers in second with 54. We had Southeastern in third with 60. We had Westfield in fourth with 84. And we had Noblesville in fifth with 102. Now, I want to keep stressing to you that these are unofficial results. We'll be getting official results soon. And when we do, we will obviously give those to you. But unofficially, we have those as your top five teams. And it went true to form on our HoosierXC.com rankings, as Carmel is ranked number one, Fishers number two, Southeastern three, and Westfield four. We have no idea who did or didn't run for any of these teams, so that really the fact that these were the results, if they are, is, you know, sort of not, doesn't foretell a whole lot come semi-state and state meet time. But at least for today, our HoosierXC.com rankings seem to hold pretty true. Perhaps the story of the day was your individual sectional champion, Ben Veach, with his impressive 14:53 winning time, destroying the course record out here. The old course record was 15:19 by Lafayette Jefferson's Tito Medrano. So, I mean, we're talking about a 26-second course record here. And as far as meet record is concerned, Mr. Hash, the Noblesville athletic director, handed me the sheet with the sectional record is 15:31. So it looks like Veach dipped 38 seconds underneath the old sectional record. So that is that's something to talk about here. You just don't get to see too many sub-15-minute performances, especially before the state finals here in Indiana. But you saw it today, 14:53 from the defending state champion, Ben Veach, from Carmel. So, what a great performance from him.
Hey. Thanks for being here.
Oh, thank you. You guys ran great. So, congratulations to the five teams who are unofficially going to be advancing here. It's going to be the Carmel Greyhounds, who we believe unofficially are your sectional champions, at 45 points. Looks unofficially like Fishers in second with 54, Southeastern in third with 60, Westfield in fourth with 84, and Noblesville in fifth with 102. Wow, that was a great race. So we catch our breath for a few moments, and we then have our girls' sectional race coming up. We haven't had a chance to talk much about the girls' race as we were getting you prepped for the boys' race. Again, we'll give you some official boys' results as they come to us. But our girls' sectional championship race is going to be starting at 11:15 approximately. I can't imagine we would be too late off of that. It's about 10:53 right now, so we've got about 20 minutes. We're hoping at some point we're going to be able to maybe get the Carmel boys coach, Coach Altivote, in here for an interview, if possible. And I'm hoping that maybe he'll be able to corral his individual champion today, Ben Veach, and we can get an interview with him as well, possibly. But the girls' race is about to start here in about 20 minutes. We want to set the field for you there. It is, much like the boys' race, probably the most competitive girls' sectional in the state of Indiana. It might not have quite the firepower that the boys' race had. The boys' race, you know, you can't get any more powerful than that. Our top three ranked teams in the state were on our HoosierXC.com rankings. We're in that boys' race. Not quite that strong in the girls' race. We'd like to start by saying that the field of the teams in the field are exactly the same for the girls. So let's run down that first. We have Carmel and HSE. We have Noblesville, Fishers, Westfield, and Garen Catholic are the six teams. And we're going to talk about that six teams here in the girls' race are ranked on our HoosierXC.com top 25 poll. That's the big difference between the boys and the girls' race here, and it is a big difference. And, again, we'll talk about that in a moment. But the rest of the field does also include Hamilton Heights, Indiana Math and Science Academy, Lebanon, Sheridan, Tipton, Tri-Central, and University. So a moment ago we talked about rankings on our HoosierXC.com poll for this girls' field, and so let's go through exactly what these teams are ranked. We mentioned that six of the teams in this field are ranked in our top 25, and that's obviously significant because only five teams get to advance here out of this brutally tough girls' sectional here at Noblesville at White River Elementary School. So in other words, I'm telling you that one of the 25 best teams in the state is going to be going home at the sectional level. Now, that's not going to happen at any other sectional in the state. So you are fortunate to get to watch this unbelievably great competition that is about to start here in about 20 minutes or so. So let's give you a rundown of which teams are in the field that are ranked in our HoosierXC.com top 25. Number one ranked Carmel Greyhounds are here, and on the girls' side. And it does look like we're going to, before we go through that with the girls field, we do have the luxury now of having the Carmel boys cross country coach. Coach Altvogt is here just after our boys race is finished, and we have no official results whatsoever yet. So we'll kind of just talk in general terms about the race. And so we've got Coach Altvogt from Carmel. Coach, unofficially, we have you winning the race. I don't know if you've been kind of doing your own tallies. We have unofficially with you at 45 points and Fishers at 54 points. But regardless of that overall result, how did you feel about your team's race?
Really good. Ben Veach set a new school record unofficially, I guess. I had him at 1454. I don't know if the official ones have come in. Their school record was about 1457.
Wow.
So kind of odd to think that he didn't have the school record, but obviously Chris Walden was a two-time,
pretty good runner,
two-time cross-country All-American. And probably would have won a couple state championships.
Okay.
Had he not been, the same time as Footsome.
And also, just so you know, I'm sure you probably do, he also broke the sectional record here by 26 seconds. I'm sorry, by 38 seconds. And
oh,
the
wow.
And the course record here by 26 seconds.
Whose record was
Tito Medrano had run the course record here in 15:19.
Okay.
From Lafayette Jefferson. So talk more about the rest of you guys in your team today.
We were thrilled. I had Ben Miller. He was our second guy today. I'm looking at my watch to get our times. I had Ben Miller at 15:43. He ran 16:01 last year, so he hadn't broken 16 minutes. Tommy Gastineau, 15:50, a freshman, and then Calvin struggled a little bit toward the end, but really held on and held some good spots. Calvin Bates at 15:58. Drew Watson was our fifth guy today, and he ran 16:04.
Wow! So you almost had that whole top five scoring group under 16 minutes today.
Yeah, and I just thought we did a really good job. Fisher's pack was incredible, and they had five guys in front of our third or fourth guy, about halfway through the race. And I think our guys just did a really good job of fighting and continuing to run. I think that. We did a really good job of fighting in the second half of the race.
Yeah, Fishers kind of did their normal thing. They like to go out aggressively, and it looked like you guys were pretty calm. You couldn't really tell, who was in the lead as a team at the halfway point, but your team really came on strong with that. So again, unofficially, we've got the Carmel Greyhounds as the sectional champions this year. We have Ben Veach breaking school record, sectional record, and course record. Sounds like it was a pretty successful day for the Greyhounds as they look forward, I'm sure, to regionals next week. Any thoughts? Is it too early to start talking about the regional?
It's never too early. Should be a good meet next week. I know that teams kind of balancing their lineup, trying to figure out who our fifth, who our sixth, who our seventh guy is. Certainly a team as deep as Fishers wanted to do that. We wanted to do that today, took off some of our fringe guys. So it'll be interesting to see what the lineups look like next week. I know Fisher's number one guy didn't run today. That could have made all the difference in the world. But really, really solid performances. I mean, these are three, really four with Westfield when they run their lineup, four really solid teams, four potential podium teams. So we're excited to come out, run really good times for the sectional and come back and ready to run next week and hopefully advance through the tournament.
Yeah, and you had told me last night you thought times would be fast today, and they certainly were. So
yeah, this is optimal weather.
Yeah, it really is. So we are getting here again unofficial results, but these are going to be a little bit more official than what I had.
I'm going to check out the time.
So it looks as though we were right. Carmel with 45, Fishers with 54, Southeastern with 60, Westfield with 84, and Noblesville with 102. Our scores
were
right on the
right
money.
Wow, on there.
And so we've got the – it's not official yet. It needs to be signed off by the official. But it looks like these are probably going to hold up as the official results today. We had 14 guys, it looks like, that broke 16 minutes today. That's pretty impressive for a sectional race where there are only 13 teams here. So
one thing I just want to point out – we got a guy, Zach Leinheiser, was one of our best guys last year, coming back from an injury. He's only been running for about 3 weeks. He finished 19th today, ran 16:10, and finished all sectional. We're just really proud of the way that Zach has been able to compete and come back from this injury. He's just done a really, really good job, and I'm glad he could come out and run today, and we'll see see if we can balance our lineup a little bit and get him a couple more races. Because I really think he could be a key guy for us in a couple weeks. He's improved so much over the last 3 weeks.
Well, we hope that is true for you guys. We want to congratulate you again on your race today. And we look forward to seeing you next week. Hopefully we'll get an interview with you next week, too.
Thanks
for stopping by. So, again, we have those official, unofficial results in here today. One thing that Coach Altavoe pointed out that we did not notice before is that Fishers' number one boy, Trevor Thompson, was not in the race today. And Fishers was still able to put their top four guys under 16 minutes and their fifth guy at 16:05. Fishers, folks, is really rolling right now after that great performance last week at the HCC Championships. They are really on fire. It had Thompson run and been, you know, in third or fourth place today, this would have been down to the wire kind of a race between Carmel and Fishers. And granted, you know, according to College Coach Altavoe, he didn't necessarily have his entire top seven running in there, but it's not like he had some slouches running today, as they had their front four all under 16 minutes as well. Also would point out that Sam Henthorn from Westfield did not run. And that's significant because he is one of the top runners in this sectional as well. You know, throw him in, you know, somewhere around 10th place, and Westfield gets down into the mix. And so, as we mentioned in the broadcast before the race has started, it's possible that you've got the best four teams in the state here in this sectional. So that's a pretty impressive field, and today that really showed with those five teams. Just to give you the rest of these unofficial results, Garin Catholic finished sixth overall, and it's probably worth mentioning that Garin Catholic, their average team time, when you score their top five guys and you add up their times, they averaged 16:59. That's unbelievably fast for a team not advancing out of the sectional. And we will talk in a moment about individuals who would advance out of the sectional here. We've talked about the teams already. But just to give you a rundown again, in fifth place was Noblesville. Their average team time was a very quick 16:14. And they had their fifth guy at 16:36. Westfield averaged 16:05. Very quick as well. Their fifth guy was 16:40. We had Southeastern averaging 15:52. And it looks like they were at full strength today, and their fifth guy was at 16:12. We had Fishers averaging 15:52 also. So the same, Southeastern averaged a couple tenths of a second faster on team time than Fishers, most likely because of the fine performance from Gabe Fendel, their top runner, who was second. So they actually averaged 15:52, as did Fishers and Carmel, in 15:41 for their average team time today. So an impressive performance up and down the board. We are also looking at an unofficial list of the 10 individuals who will be advancing on to the Noblesville Regional, and that would be Quinn Gallagher, freshman from Garin Catholic, Nathan Wire, a senior from Lebanon, Kent Linton, Jacob Washlock, Riker McPhail, Patrick Berger, and Jackson Street, all from Garin Catholic. So Garin will be advancing 6 individuals of that top 10. University's Grant Syrick will be advancing. Lebanon's Thomas Vierkamp will be advancing. And Tipton's Jacob Mahaney will be advancing. So at this point, we can say unofficially that we know who the five boys teams are that will be advancing on to the Noblesville Regional, which will be held right here, same time, same place, next week, 10:30 a.m. for the Noblesville Regional race. So we know those five teams that are moving on the boys' side, and unofficially, we know the teams that will be moving on in the, as far as individuals will be moving on to the Noblesville Regional as well. So with that, we're going to kind of wrap our boys' coverage up for the time being and get back into our discussion of the girls' races. They're about to start here in about 5 minutes. We talked about the number one ranked Carmel Greyhounds. We interviewed their fine coach, Mark Ellington, earlier in the day here. He's excited about this competition. His team will be facing some other ranked teams, in fact, six of them. Number 14 on our HoosierXC.com poll, the HSC Hamilton Southeastern Royals. They have won the Wildcat Classic this year. We have the number 16 Noblesville Millers. They won the Meconaqua Invitational this year, as well as the Noblesville Hokum Carum, a relay race. We have the number 20 Fishers Tigers. They were the Delta Invitational champions this year. We have the number 21 Westfield Shamrocks. They were the Brebeuf champions at the Brebeuf Harvey Invitational this year. And we have number 24 ranked Garin Catholic. Again, these are all in our HoosierXC.com rankings. They were second to Westfield at the Brebeuf Harvey Invitational. They were second at the Indiana All-Catholic Meet. And if you remember all the way back, if you were with us and you've been following all our races on HamiltonCountyTelevision.com this year, all the way back to the Hamilton County Meet, Garin Catholic actually defeated Fishers and Westfield at that meet. That's important to note because really the story today, as far as teams are concerned, is really probably this battle for who are going to be the last couple of advancing team, or really the last advancing team or two from this race. Now, we've talked about it before. The top five teams overall in this race, this girls' race, will be advancing on to the Noblesville Regional. Top five teams, yet six of the teams in this field are ranked in our top 25. So one of those top 25 teams, their season is going to end today. At this point in the season, Fishers, Westfield, and Garin Catholic have yet to defeat Carmel, Hamilton Southeastern, or Noblesville. Now, that doesn't mean they won't today, of course. You never know what's going to happen. But if form holds true to what's happened throughout the course of this season, then what you're really looking at is you're looking at maybe a battle between Fishers, Westfield, and Garin Catholic, those three teams, for two spots. So, again, you never know what's going to happen. You don't know who's running for which teams, who's sick, who's healthy, all that good stuff. But if form holds true, if our rankings hold true, it would seem that the Greyhounds would be the heavy favorites here in the girls' race. Hamilton Southeastern and Noblesville have kind of gone back and forth all year. They're ranked 14th and 16th in the state, so that, you know, shows they're fairly even teams. They would probably battle out for the runner-up spot in third position today. And then fourth and fifth comes down to this very tight battle between the Fishers Tigers, the Westfield Shamrocks, and the Garin Catholic Golden Eagles. So to give you an idea, we've got the girls' teams heading to the starting line here. Sorry, I paused right there. I was just getting some text messages coming in. It looks like we're getting some unofficial results from the Brebeuf sectional, and that is the other sectional that will feed into the Noblesville Regional next week. So the top five teams from the Brebeuf sectional, they would face the top five teams here from the Noblesville sectional, and that would be your 10-team field next week at the Noblesville Regional. It looks like the Cathedral Boys were the sectional champions out there, maybe in a mild upset over the host Brebeuf Braves. Brebeuf finished second. Lawrence North finished third. It looks like Bishop Chatard finished fourth, and North Central finished fifth. So unofficially, those will be the five teams that will toe the line here next Saturday against Carmel, Fishers, Southeastern, Westfield, and Noblesville in what is just a bloodbath of a regional. By far the best regional in the state next week, and we'll get you all set for that with our coverage next week as well. So,
I talked to Beach just now. He said he's rushing. He has to rush off to his school down there and catch a flight to get a school visit, but if you want, I can play the interview I got with him.
We'll see. I will just see what comes, but I appreciate that. I do. Thank you. So that's what we've got unofficially from the Brebeuf sectional. Our girls' race here at Noblesville is going to be starting in about 5 minutes. As you can see, teams are doing their final runouts. Looks like Carmel's wearing the yellow over blue. It's looking like Westfield is going to be in all black. Lebanon's going to be in all black. Looks like Fishers is going to be red over black. It looks like Noblesville is in all black. We got a lot of black jerseys here today. So it looks like Garin Catholic is also wearing all black. So we'll do our best as the race is going on to give you an idea. But what you're probably going to hear us saying is there's a lot of black in the middle of the field here. So, but we will do our best. Remember, we have this awesome footage of camera angles that are brought to you by HamiltonCountyTelevision.com. And you're going to get a camera angle of, you know, the main part of the course, but you're also going to get an angle of the finish line and the finish line clock as well. So we'll certainly get a glimpse of everybody as they come in. And we'll get you those unofficial scores, sort of like what we did in the boys' race. And then we'll await the official results that our timing company will give to us. And again, they're not made official until the starter signs off on it. So even though we have sort of those unofficial results from the boys race, we think that they're probably right, but I guess technically they're not official just yet. Just a couple minutes now before the start of the girls race, we could talk about the individuals to watch in this race. Again, not sure exactly, you know, who's running for each team. As I'm looking out at the Carmel girls on the starting line, I don't think I see Sarah Leinheiser. Sarah is their top runner, has been this year. She's the only girl in this from any of the teams in the sectional who has broken the 18-minute marker for girls cross country this year. So it does not appear as though Sarah is on the line. Carmel ranked number 10 in the United States of America, and such a deep team, they can afford to not run one of their top runners and probably still not have a problem pulling out a sectional championship here today. So that would mean that the individual title could be very much up for grabs. There's some great runners in here. I mean, Carmel has other fine runners like sophomore Maddie Dalton, junior Christina Geisler. You've got Noblesville's Abby Little running on her home course. Stacy Marizov from Carmel is also a fine runner. Devin Leahy from Westfield has run under 18:45. In fact, all those girls that I just mentioned have run under 18:45 this season. So it could be anybody's race. So the individual battle out here could be really the one to watch, as well as this awesome battle for the last qualifying spots out of here. So we've got the girls' race about to start here in just a couple minutes. Our final teams are heading to the starting line. Our official actually, I don't see our official. Oh, he's walking up and down the starting line here. He's giving his final instructions. Looks like the race may start a minute or two late. But it just does add to the suspense here, as the nerves are certainly mounting for the athletes, coaches, and fans of the teams, particularly from Fishers, Westfield, and Guerin Catholic, as two of those three schools will advance and one will not. I would point out that last year it was Guerin Catholic who placed fifth here and earned that last spot out of this Noblesville sectional. It was the Westfield Shamrocks that finished sixth and did not advance as a team last year. So you got to figure they're running with some motivation here today. The Shamrocks are, although I'm sure everybody is. So anyway, we are about to get underway. As you can see on our camera angle there, the starter is asking the athletes to take a step back. And he'll be walking out to his spot where he will shoot the gun. And he's just blown the whistle there. So it looks like he's going to head out to his spot here in just a moment. And sectional action for the girls will begin momentarily. Again, we've got a lot of teams wearing black jerseys, so it's going to be tough from our angles to tell exactly who's who. We'll do our best. Expect to see an incredible, incredible race here, just as we did last year. It will be close. It's almost impossible for it not to be. Teams that are ranked 1st, 14th, 16th, 20th, 21st, and 24th on our HoosierXC.com poll this week from across the state of Indiana, making this by far the most competitive girls sectional in the state of Indiana. And we are about to get started here as the starter is heading out. It's a great camera angle there of the starting line, as you can see. These teams have been working incredibly hard all season to try to earn a spot at the Noblesville Regional. And from there, the Noblesville Regional qualifiers will advance to the Carmel Semi-State, held at Northview Church. And the top six teams at the Carmel Semi-State will advance to the state finals at Terre Haute, Laverne Gibson. Starter is out. He's got the flag. He's blown the whistle. The gun is up, and the girls are out. So it'll be very interesting to see how this race plays out, especially amongst those teams vying for the bottom, those last two qualifying positions. It's high school athletics. You never know what's going to happen. So the girls' race is underway. We're just 20 seconds into the race. Looked like it was an honest start to the race. And we'll be giving you coverage all the way through. You want to do an interview? Do you have results?
We can walk out. But it was more important about what we did individually.
So the girls' race is underway, and we're going to be giving you as much footage as we can as they head out on the north side of this course. And the north side of the course will take the athletes through the mile marker and into the first of two woods loops. The woods loop is 1 kilometer, and they run that twice, just like the same course the boys ran, 5 kilometers, 3.1 miles. After two woods loops, then they head back north, and for the last kilometer essentially, and then head into the finish line. Hopefully we'll get to see as much excitement as we did in the boys' race with our 14:53 clocking for our champion Ben Veach breaking a school, course, and sectional record out here. And we had 14 boys breaking the 16-minute marker, and that was without some teams running their full squads, and with boys who are capable of breaking 16 minutes. So I imagine the Noblesville Regional next week will not disappoint. We're 2 minutes into the race, so you can start to see in our camera angle there, girls are bunched up early. Nobody wanted to hammer it out. Looks like we've got about a lead pack of about 6 to 9 girls with maybe a 3-meter gap to the next group of six, about 9-11 girls. So the top 20 all within shouting distance of each other. I think that's probably that was probably expected here in the girls' race early on, as it looks like Sarah Leinheiser from Carmel is not towing the line here for the Greyhounds. So it could be anybody's race out here. Individually, Greyhounds definitely favored, but certainly the race to watch, not only from an individual perspective as to who will win overall, but the excitement for those last couple of spots. Our fourth place team and fifth place team here with 6 of the top 25 ranked teams on our HoosierXC.com poll this week. So we are well underway, and we are probably approaching near the kilometer marker, and we'll get a glimpse of that area in our camera angle here that we have right now. So 3 minutes and 10 seconds, we're coming up to that marker. I'd expect the lead girls to be coming through the kilometer somewhere around 3 minutes and 30 seconds. There you can see our lead girls on our camera angle. Difficult to tell exactly who's in the lead at this point. It looks like we've got a Carmel jersey. That's Abby Little. We've got another Carmel jersey, and maybe Devin Leahy from Westfield as your front four. Although it is difficult to say from this angle, I think that might be the front four. It looks like then there's a gap back to HSE's top two, and then there's another gap back to a group of about 15 girls in places about 5 through 20. And then it gets gapped, and that's interesting in this field because gaps are going to be difficult to make up, it would seem, on this fine of a day of running. I wouldn't expect teams to come back super, super hard today. So very interesting that some gaps have already started to form. Now you're going to get to see the lead runners coming through on our next camera angle here pretty soon as they approach the mile marker coming up soon. You can see television footage right now, you got the view of the field, and then you've got in the upper right-hand corner, athletes will be coming around the bend there, and then the bottom two camera angles are showing the finish line, and then, of course, the clock. So we're going to start to see, I think, our lead girl runner coming through the woods here. I shouldn't say the woods, coming around the tree area. The woods loop is the middle 2 kilometers of the course. But from our angle, we haven't seen anybody pop through just yet. Probably hear the crowd swell a little bit when that top runner, group of runners comes around the bend. But we should be seeing them any moment, I imagine, at this point. It looked like in our camera angle, there we go, we see them a little bit. It looked like earlier that it was 2 Carmel girls and Noblesville girl, and it was difficult to tell who the fourth place girl was, although rest assured she's probably wearing black because just about every team is in there today. So from our angle, it looks like we've got Carmel girl leading the race. Looks like she's stepped it out, maybe about a 5-7 meter lead. So in the last 2 minutes, it looks like a Carmel girl's established herself as the front runner in the race. It might be Stacy Morozov from Carmel. who's heading around the bend now towards the mile marker. We are at a very, very honest pace here. Our lead runner coming through, it looks like, right at the 5:30 marker. Right at 5:30. So that is a quick opening mile in this girls' race. If she can hold on to that pace, we're talking about a very fast time. That is not Stacy Morozov leading. I might have been wrong. That might be Sarah Lienheiser. So it looks like Carmel in second, a Noblesville girl in third. Cannot tell. Maybe another Noblesville girl in fourth. Looks like two Southeastern girls are running with Devin Leahy from Westfield. And another gap back to, it's looking like, Fishers. And then a big pack. So it's going to be very difficult for us to tell. The only thing I think that is worth noting right now are the large gaps, which are always difficult to make up in a race like this. And gaps had already started here in the first 6 minutes of the race. So certainly there's a lot of running left to do in the race, as the runners are just past the one-third marker of the race. But it is difficult for to make up huge gaps. So we're 6 minutes and 30 seconds into this race, as now our girls' field is now pretty much all headed into the Woods Loop. And remember, they're running this Woods Loop twice, okay? It's a 1 kilometer loop that they're going to be running twice, and I'm just guessing that this is probably where the race is going to be made, and we're going to be able to see which teams hopefully are starting to establish themselves both as teams in the lead and teams that are sort of pulling away for those last couple of qualifying spots. 7 minutes into the race, the lead runners have probably now just passed the 2 kilometer marker, so we're about 40% of the way done with the race. We'll probably be seeing the lead runners coming around the bend here in just about a minute, minute and a half at the most, and we'll be able to get you a better idea of who's in the lead. I think I said that earlier that Sarah Lienheiser was not in the race. That may have been her. That may have not been her in the front. We're just not sure from our angle. She is Carmel's, been their top runner all year long. And whoever that was from Carmel, I can say this. She had established a pretty good lead and was definitely not messing around in the first mile, going through the mile marker at about 5:30. Which would be, you know, about 17:20 pace, which is just that would be the fastest time in the state this year for any girl, if that pace was able to be held. Now, that will be a difficult pace to hold, but I guess you never know, right? So we are anxiously anticipating our lead runner coming around the bend here at about the halfway point of the course will be the spot where I will be able to see at least a little bit of the field. And I imagine we're going to see that lead runner coming through any moment now in this 2015 IHSAA Girls Noblesville Sectional Race. Carmel is clearly the favorite. It's the number 1 ranked team in the state and the number 10 ranked team in the United States. But it is a great field here, no question. Okay, we now have our lead runner from Carmel. Still cannot tell who that is at 8:47 at my angle. And actually, it looks as though she has approximately about a 6-second lead over a teammate. And then it looks like Abby Little in third from Noblesville. The fourth runner looks like another Noblesville runner. Devin Leahy in fifth from Westfield. Hard to tell, like Southeastern and Southeastern. I see Fishers is number 1. Southeastern has 2 more. Nobles, looks like a good battle between Noblesville and IHSAA as we expected. Again, difficult to tell. So many schools are wearing black uniforms. It's very hard to tell who's who, especially between Westfield, Garin, and Noblesville all wearing black. Looks like I'm seeing Westfield's 4th and 5th girls pass there, but I have no idea where they're at in comparison to Garin's pack or Fisher's pack. So certainly, as we expected, it looks like it's a close race for sure. Lead runners have now wrapped around, and they're starting to head for their second of 2 Woods Loops here. We are nearing now the 10-minute marker. We are now 10 minutes into this race. So you'd expect to see the lead runner, the winner of this race, in about 7.5 to 8 minutes, somewhere in that vicinity. So there's still plenty of racing left to go, though we are well past the halfway point of this Noblesville sectional race. The tension and anxiety is building here as we watch these athletes giving it their all out here today. Definitely pushing all the way to the max to try to advance to the Noblesville Regional, which will be here, same place, same time next Saturday. And we will have a webcast for you from HamiltonCountyTelevision.com and HoosierXC.com. We'll be out here just like we were last week at the HCC meet and just like we were out here today. But unfortunately, one of these top 25 ranked teams in this girls' race will not be advancing to the regional competition next week, and we'll just have to wait to see which team that's going to be as we come now towards the 11-minute marker of the race. We're 11 minutes in. I imagine we're going to probably see our lead runner pretty soon. Now, she had a 5-second gap on a teammate the last time that we saw. 5-second gap. So we'll see if she still has the lead, number one, and number two, if that lead has extended at all or if the pack caught her. It looked like there was a Noblesville girl, I'm guessing Abby Little, who is in third, and it was a black jersey in fourth, and so many teams are wearing black today, it was hard to tell who that was. Okay, are we getting leaders coming through just yet? Not yet. We should be seeing them coming through and finishing out their second Woods Loop. Then they will head back north. They'll head back north for their last 12 to 1,300 meters of the race. We will get a really good view of them with about 1,200 meters left, and we'll try to give you an idea of what's going on in the race at that point. So far, here we go. We have our lead runner coming through now. Our lead runner lapping people on the second Woods Loop. Is what I had her clocked at my vantage point. And second is at 12:24, so a 6-second lead. It's Carmel 1-2. It is Noblesville girl in third. That we feel pretty confident in saying. Fourth place has a big gap now to fourth place. And it looks like that is Devin Leahy along with an HSE girl and possibly Garen Catholic's number one runner. And then HSE's number two, although it could be a Noblesville girl there. It's a black uniform. I don't think it's a Westfield uniform. We got Carmel behind that pack, and it's strung out quite a bit, folks. Quite a bit. I think I'm seeing Westfield's number two runner there in the top 10. All right, we're going to switch it around. I'm going to start looking out here at about 1,200 meters to go where I'll get a little bit better vantage point. There's our leader from Carmel in first place, as we had mentioned a moment ago. And it looks like she's maybe extended her lead out by a second or two over teammate. It looks like that's Stacy Morozov in second. I'm guessing that's Abby Little then in third from Noblesville. And then there's a bit of a gap back to a pack in fourth, fifth, and sixth. And earlier we thought that that looked like Devin Leahy from Westfield running with Southeastern's top runner, who is typically, well, it looks like Southeastern's top runner, that's either Bippus, it looks like it might be Laurel Black, as Devin Leahy is trying to hang on to her. It looks like that is either a Noblesville runner or a Garen runner behind Leahy, and that actually really matters in the team scoring. So we'll try to get a glimpse of that, although from our angle, it's going to be tough to tell. It looks like that's a Garen Catholic runner in sixth. Looks like Southeastern Sabrina Bippus in seventh. And then there's a gap back to eighth place, and that looks like another Noblesville runner, maybe in eighth. Southeastern in ninth. Fishers in tenth. And then we've got Southeastern in 11th. We've got Lauren Bailey, it looks like, from Westfield in 12th. Another Southeastern runner in 13th. It looks like there's fourth Carmel runner in 14th. It looks like maybe that's Garen's number two. Very difficult to tell. Very difficult to tell at this point. Oh. Looks like I'm seeing Fishers is number two. There's Fishers is number three, four, and five. It looks like Westfield's three and four is right with them. Guys, this is a really tough one to call. It's looking like maybe Fishers has the edge for the fourth place spot. It might come down to Westfield and Garen Catholic for that last qualifying spot, much like it did last year. So we will see. We are at 15 minutes into the race. We anticipate lead runners coming through here, our leaders to come through the finish line here well under the 18-minute marker. Under the 18-minute marker. It looked like Carmel had established the top two in the race. And Then after that, it looked like Noblesville's Abby Little was in third place. And then it looked like maybe Laurel Black from Southeastern had pulled out into fourth with Westfield's Devin Leahy in fifth. And then that sixth place spot was difficult to tell who that was, whether that was another Noblesville runner or the top Garin Catholic runner. And I think it might have been the top Garin Catholic runner, which is going to make today a very, very close race, obviously, between those two teams as they head down in here towards the finish line area. So we're going to get our score pad ready here so that we can start trying to get you unofficial results. Now, one thing I will say, with the field as bunched up and in packs, but then as spread out, those packs are very spread out as it is, we should be able to get you some unofficial results that are at least somewhat accurate. So we will see, as runners will be streaming in here probably in about a minute and a half. I think you'll see your first lead runner, your sectional champion, coming in soon. So we've got about, like I said, about a minute and a half, maybe a little less than a minute and a half, till we see our sectional champion emerge, our individual sectional champion emerge. It did look indeed as though the Carmel Greyhounds had command of the race. Looked like the Southeastern Royals were running well. 16:40. We are now about a minute left in the race. We should see our lead runner pop out into our camera angle any second here. It should be any moment that we see our lead runner coming through with about 200 meters left in the race. We are now at the 17-minute marker. And there it is. Nope, those are fans. Sorry. It should be any moment. I'm seeing people starting to rush out to a spot, so that means it's going to be soon. Now, this does mean that that 18-minute marker may not be broken today. As we see our lead runner coming through now, as you see her coming into the camera angle, it is a Carmel runner in first place, and it looks like her teammate is in second. So we're going to probably see a 1-2 finish from Carmel. Looks like that is Maddie Dalton from Carmel, if I see that correctly, and Stacy Morozov in second. It looks like Abby Little from Noblesville is going to be your third-place finisher. Those are going to be your top three. Now it's just a question of how fast the time will be. We are at 17:46 right now, and it looks like we're going to see a sub-18-minute run from Maddie Dalton, I believe that is, from Carmel, and 17:55. Her teammate Morozov also going to crack in 17:59. She's going to crack the 18-minute barrier, and 18:03, a new PR for Noblesville's Abby Little. So a very quick race up front for those three. It went Dalton, Morozov, Little, and now the battle comes for team title. It's Devin Leahy who has pushed out into fourth place with a new PR for her as well in 18:22, and that is going to be HSE's Bippus and HSE's Laurel Black in fifth and sixth, all six under 18:30, taking advantage of the awesome conditions out here. This is Noblesville's number two runner that was not a Garin Catholic girl, running 18:40. It was Garin Catholic. I couldn't tell who got there, so we're going to say it went Garin, then Noblesville. We've got Carmel's third, and then we've got Fisher's top girl in 18:50. We've got Noblesville's third. Then it's going to go Carmel, Westfield, HSE. We're talking all under 19:05. Wow. We've got another HSE girl coming in at 19:09. That's Southeastern's fourth, I believe. Here comes Fisher's number two. We've got Garin Catholic's number two. So Westfield, a slight edge on them through two. They might have needed a bigger edge than that. We've got Southeastern followed by Noblesville, Garin, Fishers, Carmel, Westfield, 19:31 for their fourth, then Fishers, Noblesville, Fishers. Carmel, Noblesville, Garin, Carmel. Garin's fifth. It looks like Garin Catholic may have pulled it off. It's going to depend on where this next runner from Westfield comes in. Fishers. That was the 20-minute marker, folks. We had a lot of girls that just broke 20 minutes. A lot. Here comes Westfield's fifth. And there's Southeastern runner. They're going to battle to the line. It's going to be HSE, then Westfield. So we can start trying to tabulate results for you now, folks. Carmel went 1-2. Noblesville in third. We have Westfield girl Devin Leahy in fourth. We have Southeastern went 5-6. Garen Catholic in seventh. Noblesville in eighth. Carmel in ninth. Fisher's number one runner in 10th. Noblesville, third girl, in 11th. Carmel, 12th. Westfield, number two, in 13th. Southeastern went 14-15. Fishers in 16th. Garen Catholic in 17th. Southeastern in 18th. They had five in before anybody else. Noblesville in 19th. Garen Catholic's third in 20th. Fishers 21. Noblesville 22. Fishers 23. Nope, I screwed that up. Garen Catholic 20. Fishers 21. Carmel 22. Westfield went 23-24. Fishers went 25. Noblesville went 26. Fishers 27. Carmel 28th. Noblesville 29-30. Garen 31. And 33. I want to double check this before I go through it. Fishers 21, Carmel 22, Westfield 23-24, Fishers 25, Noblesville 26, Fishers 27, Carmel 28, Noblesville 29 and 30, Garen 31. All right, let's do it. Let's work backwards so we can get this unbelievably close battle between Garen and Westfield. It looks like 64, 84, 91, 108 for Garen, and 60, 83, 96, 100. I've got I've got Westfield unofficially fifth. Unofficially, I have Westfield in fifth. Don't get too excited. Unofficially, Westfield at 100, Garen at 108. Unofficially, very unofficially. This was an interesting race, a very interesting race. We had Southeastern had five runners in before Carmel. That's the 10th ranked team in the U.S. Now, again, we don't know how at full strength Carmel ran today, but that was interesting. Let's add up our Fishers total next. They were at 52, 73, 89. They were at 99, so they only eked out Westfield by one, it looks like, for that last spot, for that fourth and fifth spot. I had Garen at 108. Wow, that's a close race for those last couple of spots, just as we had anticipated. We got 33, 47, 53. We got 58 for Southeastern. And we've got 34, 43, 40, 46 for Carmel. So we've got, oh, I didn't do Noblesville. We've got 45, 56, 59, 67 for Noblesville. So our unofficial scores here, and I want to make it clear that it's unofficial. Were you doing this too? Okay. I've got unofficially, I've got Carmel with 46. I've got Southeastern with 58. Noblesville at 67. And then it got really cool. It was Fishers 99, Westfield 100, and Garen Catholic 108. We are now going to be joined once again, and very generously, I might add, by Carmel Girls head coach Mark Ellington. We are going to be here live on the camera here with Coach Ellington, the girls coach from Carmel. So obviously, we have unofficial results. We don't even worry necessarily about the total team score since they are very unofficial. Just give us a general Just give us a general impression of how your team ran today.
Not having seen times, but looking especially at our final 2K in that race, I'm actually pretty pleased. I know the team score is probably not going to bear out that we're some dominant state team, but if I look at the girls that we ran today, we had a lot of PRs. And that final 2K, there was a lot of stalking at the end of that race. And there were some girls that really came through at the end of our race. Just did a great job today. I'm really pleased, and I know it's not going to show like we were this awesome team, but I look at the times. I think we might have had 218.
You did.
Real close.
Yeah, was that Stacy in second?
Stacy was in second.
Yeah, I had her at 17:59.
Okay, she'll be very tickled to know that's the first time she's been under 18.
I was unofficial, but yeah, no.
Okay.
And the times were blazing out here today.
Yeah.
It looked like, I want to say, it might have been the entire top 8 runners, I think, were under 18:40.
Wow.
I mean, it was really fast today. So generally speaking, you're happy with your performance. It looks like unofficially the Carmel Greyhounds are the sectional champions today. Is it too early to start to anticipate for the regional? And I mean, is there obviously, I'm sure you're excited about that race as well.
Sure.
Do you anticipate the competition being similar from the other teams, or maybe even greater because the other sectional that'll feed in here?
Well, obviously we have a really good sectional here, so everybody who's moving on is going to be great. So I think we'll probably anticipate, and if I remember right, Cathedral comes into the regional.
Yes,
so
yes.
Yeah, you can't sleep on them. I think often we miss that, and Catherine Free is going to be outstanding as an individual. So yeah, we're going to retool and get going. And, you know, we already have our lineup ready, so you'll see a couple girls again next week, but you'll probably see a whole new crew of 4 or 5 other girls come in. So we'll be ready to go.
That's
and the weather
awesome.
Will be different. Of course,
oh,
the
yeah.
conditions will be different, so
yeah.
We'll get after it again.
Well, showing off their depth today with the fine performance, the Carmel Greyhounds, unofficially your sectional champs. Thanks for stopping by, Coach.
You.
We really appreciate it.
Yep. Thanks for the coverage.
So, again, I'm just sort of in kind of a wow moment right here. The times were so quick, and I guess that should have been anticipated with the course conditions that we have. Unofficially, we've got Carmel at 46, Southeastern at 58, we've got Noblesville at 67. We had then came the really interesting battle, and that's why we want to stress that this is very unofficial. We had the Fishers Tigers at 99 in fourth, with Westfield at 100, 1 point back in fifth, and Garin Catholic in 108 in sixth. This is unofficial, very unofficial. So we will await the official results to come to us.
What? 5 minutes, maybe? I know Gabby was Brown was 1931, and that was your fourth.
So, okay. So, like I said, I'm just sort of still in that little bit of wow based on those times. I can't wait, actually, to get the official result sheet, not only to see if our team results were correct, but also to just get an idea. You break 20 minutes in girls cross country, and you're a good runner. I mean, there's no question about that. And, I mean, it was a huge chunk of this field that was under the 20-minute marker today. And, again, it's just a testament to the fine athletes and fine coaches in this Noblesville sectional to have their teams as prepared and ready to go for this race as they were. And the top 5 teams from this race, they will advance onto the Noblesville Regional next week, which is going to be, once again, unbelievably close, because you're going to throw into that race the top 5 teams from the Brebeuf sectional. They'll come over here. And as Coach Ellington from Carmel noted, that includes the Cathedral Irish, who are one of the top 10 teams in Indiana. So much like this week on the girls' race, next week, again, one of the top 25 teams in the state, maybe even one of the top 20 teams in the state, are going to be knocked out at the regional level, be unable to compete as a team at the semi-state level. So we'll see. You know, we can't wait for that race, and we are going to be bringing that to you live 1 week from right now, same time, same place, Noblesville Regional, next Saturday, 10:30 a.m. We'll come on the air if all goes well at 10:30. 7:15 a.m. here at HamiltonCountyTelevision.com. We cannot wait for that. The boys' race going to be incredible. We just gave you the unofficial results from the Brebeuf Sectional, the Cathedral Irish, the Brebeuf Braves went 1-2. Those are top 20 ranked teams. You know, add that into the top three boys' teams here. With the Carmel boys, the Fishers boys, the Southeastern boys, and then the number 7 Westfield boys who are outstanding today. And girls are down here. So the competition next week is going to, if it's possible, surpass the competition that we had this week. I guess that's how it should be, considering it's the next round of the IHSAA tournament. But we cannot wait to bring you that footage live from HamiltonCountyTelevision.com and HoosierXC.com. We are awaiting the results, the official results to the girls' championship race here, the girls' sectional championship race. Imagine the timing group is taking their time. These results were very, very close, and obviously these it's a matter of, you know, who's advancing out from this sectional to the regional, so they want to make sure they get it right. So we'll try to bring you those results as quickly as we can once they're made official. But we have unofficially, actually not in the same order, but the same 5 teams advancing in the boys' race as the girls. So we have the Carmel boys and Carmel girls advancing. We've got the Noblesville boys and Noblesville girls advancing, Southeastern boys and girls advancing, the Fishers boys and girls advancing, and the Westfield boys and girls advancing. Again, all unofficial still. Going back through just to double check my notes. It does appear that that is the case, though, unofficially. It's possible that we are still waiting on another runner to finish the race before we will actually get results in hand. But wow, what a day of racing out here. I mean, this is what high school cross country is all about. Young men and women who have worked incredibly hard to accomplish big goals and then put it on the line on the big day. And for many of them, this is the big day. And for some, you know, it'll be next week. And others, it'll be semi-state. And for the elite, the absolute elite, it'll be the state meet. But and then showing great sportsmanship. It seemed like so many of the teams here were so excited about their performances and their teammates' performances. So we are so proud to bring you high school athletics from HamiltonCountyTelevision.com and from HoosierXC.com. Now, on HoosierXC.com, we will be posting an article about this meet. We'll be putting that up tomorrow at some point if all goes well. We'll have some pictures courtesy of Dave Takeyoshi from Line 11 Photography. He is our photographer for HoosierXC.com. And so we'll have an article about that if you go to HoosierXC.com tomorrow. We'll have our latest top 25 statewide rankings. They will post on Monday. And I would imagine that some of these teams that you watch today are going to be moving up in the overall rankings because of the unbelievably fast times that they ran out here today. So we will be posting that on Monday. And then on Tuesday, we will have our Athlete of the Week, Statewide Athlete of the Week, and Team of the Week that we will be posting. So we've got lots of great stuff coming up in the next few days. So come to HoosierXC.com often and check out our coverage. And again, go to HamiltonCountyTelevision.com for all kinds of great high school sports coverage, movies, TV shows, just terrific stuff. So we are still awaiting official results. It looks like I'm going to get a set right here really quickly. Okay, so we're going to kind of run down unofficially. It looks like our scores were exactly correct, folks. Our scores were exactly right on, and so we will run down through that again, as it looks like our scores were right on the money. Carmel will be your Noblesville sectional champion with a score of 46. Interestingly, their boys scored 45. And it's going to be Southeastern, Hamilton Southeastern Royals. We're second, only 12 points back behind the Greyhounds. Now, you heard Coach Ellington, the fine coach from Carmel, come up and say that he did not run his full squad today. The coaches have that luxury as they get to enter 12 names on their sectional roster, and then they run seven here at the sectional level. But they were able to defeat the Southeastern Royals, who had a fine race today as they came in second with 58 points. Thank you. In third were the Noblesville Millers. Perfect, thank you. In third, Noblesville Millers with 67 points. Fourth place, as we mentioned, Fishers with 99. And fifth, Westfield with 100. So that could be quite the battle next week at the IHSA Regional. Unfortunate for Garen Catholic that they won't be advancing this year, particularly when you mentioned that their average team time was 19:26, and that does not make it out of the sectional level. Something should probably be done about that from the IHSA folks. That's my opinion. Those were your top six teams here today. We want to give you a rundown now of the individual race because, as we mentioned, it was an incredible 34 girls that broke 20 today. 34 girls broke the 20-minute marker. That is pretty, pretty impressive. And the field was led by Carmel's Maddie Dalton, who ran 17:56, and her teammate, Stacy Morozov, in second. We had her at 17:59, but officially she was actually at 18.0. So that was second place. Abby Little from Noblesville, third in 18:03. Devin Leahy from Westfield in fourth at 18:22. And you're really talking about new PRs for most of that top five. And when you also throw in Sabrina Bippis from Southeastern at 18:25 and her teammate Laurel Black in sixth at 18:30. In seventh was Megan Slamkowski from Garen Catholic in 18:41. She'll be advancing as an individual. Sarah Baldwin from Noblesville in 8th, 18:41 also. Megan Kress in 9th from Carmel in 18:48. And Mia Y from Fishers would round out top 10 in 18:51. Just want to mention the average team times here. Carmel averaged 18:38 for their top five. Southeastern averaged 18:54. Noblesville averaged 18:57. Fishers 19:21. And interestingly, Westfield in 5th averaged 19:19, which is 2 seconds faster than what Fishers averaged. So that just underscores how close the race was between Westfield and Fishers, and how interesting that battle is going to be next week, as those two teams will be vying for some of the last spots to qualify out of the Noblesville Regional and make it to the Carmel semi-state. As we mentioned, Garen Catholic averaged 19:26 in sixth place. That average team time would win of a lot of sectionals statewide. So as expected, today was a day of excitement here at Noblesville at the IHSA Noblesville Sectional. Terrific, terrific racing from awesome athletes. And we were proud to bring the coverage to you from HoosierXC.com and from HamiltonCountyTelevision.com. Remember that we are going to be live here next week again at 10:15, starting our coverage of the IHSA Noblesville Regional. So come back, join us next Saturday as we look forward to much, much more great cross-country action from the state of Indiana. But we are now signing off. Thanks for joining us.